Ever wonder if hunting for a special bus is a mission, or exploring through joyride buses will take us to and discover some of the places that such interesting route goes? Let's discover through our public buses in Singapore. On today's episode of Discovery Buses in Singapore, we'll be showing you those bus services with point loops. Point loop means that the bus route that will be characterized by a single looping point. It can be roundabout or three-point turn. Since there are so many bus services in Singapore that involves point loop, Admin will share with you my 4 personal favorite point loop bus services. And here we go!
Thank you for traveling with SMRT buses.
Service 962 is a loop bus services between Woodlands and Admiralty Street via Sembawang. This brings back old memories of my bendy bus joyride, as it is fun to see the articulator been bending in this particular roundabout. Unfortunately, the fun has come to an end when the bus fleet of Service 962 went into double deck back in 2018. Although the debut deployment is 1 year before. But the problem about this roundabout is that there will be vehicles parking at the side of the roundabout, so bus captains have to be slowly turned one whole round back, especially looking out at the near side mirror. Best Tahu ever with old bendy buses in this bus service. Do you remember the early episode of Fun Fair Friday, where we talk about services 181, 185, and 600? This legendary loopy point here in Jurong West that makes an unsolved mystery of why service 181 can't be classified as feeder service. Back then, this loopy point was being done as a 3-point turn. Until a few months back, the land of that particular area has finally been occupied, and it involves taking up the 3-point turn loop and make it as a roundabout loop for temporary. There goes the history of his 3-point loop for service 181 that brings the image of the unsolved mystery of the 3 bus services. Everyone should know this place in the furthest northeast. Back then, this Punggol Road end is the bus terminal until in 2003, when Punggol Temporary Interchange opens. Service 84 were introduced to replace the lost sector of Service 82 back in 2011, where this is a popular spot for Coney Island and OBS. This loopy point is an iconic landmark of Punggol Road End. However, we can tell that this loopy point will become a history of treasure, as this bus service will likely to be served Punggol North Integrated Transport Hub in the future. Until then, Service 84 will be given a full 100% makeover from its direct bus service between Punggol Town Centre and Punggol Road End into serving HDB BTO Estate and Punggol Digital Hub. Named as Singapore's second shortest feeder service, Service 284 serves the housing estate of Clementi Avenue 4. Although it is very short distance of 1.8 km, it is still needed to be served by a feeder service to cater within the area to and for Clementi Mall. So this is how the point loop were being built specially for Service 284. And that's why the point loop is much extended so that buses can eventually loop at ease, unless there's any assholes who will park at that area. Not just Service 284, but City Direct Service 667, as well as and former Chinatown CT28 that were being used to ply in this sector before it began to withdraw back in 2017. We're pretty sure that there are a lot of bus services with these point loops, so tell us what are other bus services that involves in these point loops? Leave your comment down below. Thank you for watching this week's episode of Discovery Buses in Singapore. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.